It's Wednesday the 8th, the day after the big pour, and already guys are taking down the forms, and I see in the back corner they're starting to lay some block for the wall. So next phase, my first walk in the slab. I've already taken most of the forms down and take the rest of them down, and they're laying the first layer of block for the master bedroom closet and baños. So they're moving right along. It's Maestro and Eric.
Buen dia.
Buen dia. Jorge, who is Francis's brother, who's kind of supervising the project while Francis is in the States, was saying yesterday how critical the first row blocks were to make sure they're square and level. So I guess today the job is to put down the first row of blocks square and level. And then we'll make some progress on several rows. Gotta get the first row straight with the string. Everything else depends on that. Francis ordered 3,000 blocks yesterday, but because there's a lot of construction going on, there's a shortage of blocks, they only delivered 1,000, so today they're delivering another 1,500 or so. Still owes a few more pallets of blocks, but the thing that's interesting is, normally they have a forklift to pick up these pallets of blocks. They didn't bring a forklift. They brought some guys. They're going to unload all these blocks, 1,500, 1,600 blocks, by hand, and stack them up here. By hand. Wow. I left here a couple hours ago to go to a dental appointment, and I come back and this is the result of all those blocks being taken off the truck and stacked by hand. These guys are probably getting tired by now. It's Thursday the 8th. This is the second day of what I'm going to call the block party. Already one load of blocks is starting to get smaller here. They'll start working on these shortly. And I think there's another 1,000 blocks coming soon. But making some progress. I think the key right now is making sure that the first layer of block is perfect. That's gonna define the wall and the perimeter of the house. So they're taking great pains to make sure every first block, every corner, is exactly where it needs to be. One thing about laying the block is it begins to, the rooms start to take shape. This will be the first bedroom. That's the garage there. That area is a closet. And this will be a door to the garage and a back way to the house. There's a door here. That'll be like a sink and a floor drain for mops and that type of thing. But then you start to see the dimensions of the house take shape. Small fixable error. This area here between that post and the corner is supposed to be a sliding glass door, so they're gonna have to knock that block out. It's Friday. More blocks are going up. This is the master bedroom and the closet and the bathroom. I'm standing right now where there's going to be a glass door that look out into the pool area. Francis said that pretty soon, maybe next week, they're going to start building the pool. They're not going to use blocks. They're going to build forms and pour it with concrete for strength and prevent any future leaks. Not exactly the way most pools are built here. Most are, are built with concrete blocks filled in. I also understand that there'll be a lot more on Monday, a lot more guys laying the block. Maestro's got a whole another crew that's gonna be coming out here. So, starting to look a little bit like a house. The other thing I found out today is the cement mixer can't actually make cement for the blocks for some technical reasons. But they're going to use it. All these forms, all these columns all over have to be boarded up, put forms around them, and poured with concrete. And that's a big task. So that's what the cement mixers, the concrete mixer is going to be for, is to mix enough concrete to fill these things up instead of having to either rent a concrete mixer or buy concrete on the big trucks. So that's the purpose of the mixer. And there are a bunch of columns. And there'll be more. For instance, that one's going to be a little taller. There's another view of where the glass door is going to be in the bedroom from that column to the edge of the wall there. And what's interesting is now we're going to see what the floor plan is going to look like and how this part, which is the living room, dining room area, is completely going to be totally open. Going to the kitchen, this will be where a large kitchen island will be built. Then we have a hallway. This will be a pantry. That will be a door to the outside. That'll be a bathroom. This is another bedroom that we'll use as an office. That'll have a sliding glass door going out. Come back here, and this will be the laundry area. Washer, dryer, sinks, etc. This is another walkway that goes back to the garage, the back door of the garage. This will be a floor drain. We'll keep mops and all that kind of stuff. Right here in the ground, this is P. P stands for Puerta, which is door. There'll be a door going outside there. So you can start to see how the house is going to be laid out by where they've got the blocks. And Francis is really excited. He says, you know, the more he sees how this thing is coming together, he's surprised that more Dominican homes are not built like this to be so open because of the fantastic climate for it. And he thinks it's going to maybe set some real trends for building here in the country, especially in some of the resort type areas. The only problem is this house, although it's not that big, takes a big lot, much bigger than most Dominican lots are. Because the first row of block is so critical to make sure they're straight, Maestro Marinito has his most skilled guys laying the first row of blocks all over the place.